Welcome. Playing this game for a good 30 odd hours now, and I'm going to find this water treasure. Well, something really cool. And then I'm going to meet a tribe later on, which is going to be a lot of fun. And that leads to, near the end of this video, leads to a cave, which I will enter in the next episode, where I fight a rather large boss. Which I wasn't expecting. Well, yeah, definitely different. Caught me off guard a lot as well. But I didn't die, I did quite well. But this game just throws curveballs at me. It's really good. I wish I had a more powerful rig so I could at least show you this in, you know, its high settings. At the moment it's just at low and medium settings. On the Steam Deck, but it's running. I have to keep the fans blowing on the external hard drive to keep it going. Because it does kind of crash when it's a bit too warm for some strange reason. Anyway, let's get stuck in and let's find this treasure, which is right below me.
Not Dalrita. I can see you're not Dalrita. I mean, I don't know all Dalrita, but you don't look like us. Don't even smell like us. Ah, and it's a good coincidence. I like good coincidences. You can learn a lot from them. That's what my brother says. Roder's not here. I don't know where he went. He got up and left in the night, and that's the last we saw of him. He's very wise. He's the pride of the Svein tribe. But he's not here. He went somewhere, and I don't know when he'll come back. Sparkles. No one else in the camp can do that. I saw Therov's magic once. He used it to kill a man during a raid. Poof! There wasn't much left of him. He looked like a roast pig. Therov once talked about a whisper in the dark, that he wants to follow that voice and tell it. Sounds like it could be a decent fight. I don't understand much. He's pissed off because he has to sit on his ass in camp. Because those are the orders. To sit here and keep watch. And he wanted to slay a monster. The Whispering One. But he can't. That's all. They call me Sobder. I made my tribe proud when I was a child. My father left me in the woods for a night. Wolves came. When he came back for me in the morning, I was already making a burrow. A wolf's belly. With these very nails. I really miss my brother. He's as proud of me as our tribe is of him. I can't leave my post. One Eye's orders. He said, not a step outside this camp, or I'll rip your legs off. Understood? I really like my legs. And I wouldn't want them ripped off. So I can't use them to go look for my brother. You're not worried about your legs? You don't like them attached to your body? If you say so. He went there. I saw him at night when he snuck out. You'll find loads of bandits there. So that's where I'd be looking, if I could. You're not Del Rita, but I like you. Your ancestors must have been great people.
Mm-hmm. Still doesn't tell me anything. First, you showed up here like a dimwit. Now you're walking around camp like it's nothing. I look into your eyes and I don't know whether you're made of steel or you're just a fool. But you're here. And Sobdair didn't chop you to pieces with his axe. The runes, they seem to favor you, even though you're an outsider. I guess that has to be enough, for now. It's still more than you should expect. If you need something, talk to Varan. She's in charge. The woman. Sobdair talks a lot, but there's not much wisdom in what he says. But he's right. If not for the orders, I would have gone searching for the Mistbearer long ago. Even the druids don't know shit about those creatures, but we talked a lot about them in my tribe. Everyone from Feud wants to face one of those wraiths, and I'd love to get my hands on one of their corpses. Those are priceless and can be used for strong magic. The Stray wants to impress the Del Rita, to show courage and goodwill. So be it. The words were spoken. Now I'll wait for proof of the deed. What of it? The Del Rita are not Camelot. We don't make women wear frocks and sit at home. Our women have names. And if they have names, it means they earned them like all other Rita. Varan was chosen by One Eye, and One Eye doesn't make mistakes. I don't need to tell you anything. Just wait and see for yourself. When the South is free from Arthur's dogs, as it should be. Go, bring glory to your ancestors. Tharov will be waiting.
Look at you. We all thought you were a madman, or just zaffed in the heat to go snooping around a camp like that, and now here you are. So, you want something, or you just came here to stare? The temple now belongs to the Del Rita. Nobody goes in unless I say so, and you don't strike me as a godly sort of person. What do you want from there anyway? You can pray somewhere else. The All Mother is everywhere, or so the priestesses say. You can even kneel right here facing the statue. I won't stop you doing that. Then I'm no stopping you either. What's that look for? I wouldn't steal an offering. What do you take me for? A Camelotian? Spoken like you were born and raised in Timberwall. Why should I even bother talking to you? I know of him. I heard he's a decent warrior, but he's no Valkyr, so I can't tell you any more than that. I should tell you that because... No or no, no any more. If Camelot wants it back, they're welcome to try. Aye, that I am, and I've no time for bullshit, so keep it short and sweet unless you want a taste of my axe.
Oi, keep your hands where I can see them. You've got balls to come here, but one wrong move and you'll lose them. Ha! That son of a bitch. I once smacked him in the mouth after he tried to sick his wolves on me. Bloody ghostly shite. You also play around with filthy magic like your friend. Yeah, to cowards and wimps. If you use it, you're either one or the other. What are you doing here? Then you have a problem. Because the temple now belongs to One Eye, and he told us to sit here on our arses and make sure no one goes inside. So, you're not going inside. But I really hope you'll try. At least I can warm myself up by chopping off your head. While you're here, why don't you make yourself useful? I'm sitting here like some wimp as if I pissed off Matyra herself, and I can't even go hunting. But you, I see, have arms, legs, eyes, and even a weapon. There's loads of game around, and I need you to kill a bear. And bring me its pelt and its claws.
For a world of hurt. Belongs to us. I see fear in your eyes. Thank you.
won't you die already?
What are you talking about? Are you insane? This is a weird worm, the biggest I've ever seen. I almost smashed it into the ground, but the damn thing just won't die. And I, grew there of the Sven tribe, must kill it or die with honor. Sobder, I know that name. Ah, the halfwit.
Oh no, this won't do. There's too much emotion. I have to do something about it.
Fight, you animal!
Thank you. Thank you.